The month of November is National Diabetes Month, and today, 14th November, is World Diabetes Day for the year 2021, a time when communities across the country team up to bring attention to diabetes. This year, the theme or the focus is on pre-diabetes and preventing diabetes. World Diabetes Day is the world's largest diabetes awareness campaign. The theme for World Diabetes Day 2021 to 2023 is access to diabetes care. New figure from the 10th edition of the Diabetes Atlas of International Diabetes Federation or IDF revealed that 537 million adults around the world are living with diabetes. Diabetes is a condition primarily defined by high blood sugar level or hyperglycemia, giving rise to risk of microvascular changes in different organs, causing different diseases like diabetic retinopathy, diabetic neuropathy, or diabetic nephropathy. It's a silent killer, so we all should be more concerned of the minute signs and symptoms of this. But as per the different research in 2021 after the global pandemic, current estimate indicates that most individuals, perhaps up to 70%, are in a pre-diabetic state, which will eventually may develop a diabetes in near future. This group is called people having impaired glucose tolerance, which means people who are high risk to develop diabetes in near future. Impaired glucose tolerance means that blood glucose is raised beyond normal levels but not too high enough to call the patient diabetic. With impaired glucose tolerance, you face a much greater risk for developing diabetes or cardiovascular disease. Treating impaired glucose tolerance may help to prevent diabetes development and lower the risk for cardiovascular disease. Now, the question comes, how often does impaired glucose tolerance develop into diabetes? 1 to 3 out of every 4 people with impaired glucose tolerance will develop diabetes within a decade or within few years. So before that, we need to know what is normal blood glucose level. We have to understand that diabetes is a chronic disease that occurs either when the pancreas does not produce enough insulin or when the body cannot effectively use the insulin it produces. Insulin is a hormone that made by your pancreas helps to bring the glucose from the bloodstream into cells of your body. Blood glucose levels are the amount of glucose in the blood, and normal fasting blood sugar concentration are between 70 mg per dl to 100 mg per dl. Next, what are the symptoms of impaired glucose tolerance and how it has been diagnosed? People who have impaired glucose tolerance often exhibit zero symptoms. Often IGT or impaired glucose tolerance is diagnosed when doctor conducts a blood test called glucose tolerance test. This test explains how your body is processing glucose. Glucose tolerance test usually takes place in the morning. After the first blood sample for blood sugar, that is fasting sample, you will drink a bottle of liquid containing a defined amount of glucose. In adults, the drink usually contains 75 grams of glucose. After you drink the glucose solution, your blood will again drawn over the next 2 to 3 hours. You should not eat anything during this time frame. When the test is completed, you will able to eat again. Now, if the test result of the second sample, that after taking 75 grams of sugar solution, shows a value of 140 to 199 mg per dl, it denotes you are pre-diabetic, which means an elevated 2-hour plasma glucose concentration more than 140 or less than 200 mg per dl after a 75 gram of glucose load are called impaired glucose tolerance. Right? So what are the risks of? People with impaired glucose tolerance face a greater risk for cardiovascular disease, including high blood pressure, increased cholesterol. Because there is no symptoms of impaired glucose tolerance or IGT, many people have the condition and they are unaware of it. Global research estimates that some globally 1 billion people are having impaired glucose tolerance at present, and you can be one of them if you are unaware of your blood glucose level. Now we will discuss the cause. Various factors increases the risk for developing impaired glucose tolerance or IGT, which includes being overweight or obese, having a positive family history of diabetes, doing little or no physical activity, having a high blood pressure or high cholesterol, or a gestational diabetes. So what are the treatment options or how impaired glucose tolerance can be treated? We have to remember that IGT is treated using lifestyle changes and a drug treatment. Apart from the normal medication, losing weight, exercising more and eating a healthy balanced diet is a key way of treating impaired glucose tolerance. Stop smoking, sticking to recommended weekly alcohol limits and keeping blood pressure in a normal range all will help to lower the risk for developing IGT or impaired glucose tolerance or to developing type 2 diabetes. So, in the occasion of World Diabetes Day, I wish we all be aware of our glucose tolerance level. If you find this video helpful, like the video, share with your friends and family, and subscribe the channel to get latest health-related medical updates.